madam. Oh, yeah, how's it treating Little Red Riding Hood? Oh, gripping stuff, isn't it? Anyway, the reason why I clicked on this video is because there is actually a version that no one's heard of before, and it's when Little Red Riding Hood was 15. Yeah. Let's put down the analogue book and get the technology out. It's why you clicked on this video, isn't it? Unless YouTube recommended you this video and you've no idea why. Here's the story about Scarlet Caperon, which is Little Red Riding Hood's real name. Are you sitting comfortably? I am. And if you're not, hurry up, get comfy, sit down, lay back, whatever. I ain't got all day. Hurry up. There we are. Scarlet Caperon. Last week, Scarlet Caperon got a new coat for her 15th birthday. It was a present from her grandma, and she really liked the coat. She'd had her eye on it for about a month and had no idea that Grandma, who is 45, would have known how to order online from Boohoo, let alone know what Boohoo was. Scarlet's mum told her not to be so bloody rude and remembered to say thank you to Grandma, who had not been feeling very well after a dodgy takeaway. Grandma was also getting really bad headaches as she was going on every single review website to talk about her toxic tortilla pizza ordeal and leaving one-star reviews wherever she could. Yesterday, Scarlet's mum came home and told Scarlet to pop to Boots and to get some Sulfadine Max Soluble, a bottle of Dettol hand sanitizer, and at this point, Scarlet looked at her mum with an incredulous facial expression and interrupted. Oh, Mum, I was going to go to Amelia and Jasmine's. We was going to dye Amelia's hair. And she looked at her phone and flopped down on the settee. Her mum was really annoyed with Scarlet's snappy attitude. Oh, you miserable little cabbage. It's for your grandma. And if you'd have actually waited till I finished, I was actually going to give you this 20 and let you keep the change. Now, you're going to take this tenner and you're going to go there and come back. Don't forget to thank Grandma for your coat. Scarlet had forgotten that although flights were still grounded and holidays cancelled, her mum's guilt trips were still in full business. She took the tenner ungraciously from her mum's hand without eye contact, grabbed her maroon coat with gold stitching and left the house quietly. But still slammed the metal garden gate so hard it swung open again and smacked against the brick fence. Scarlet's mum shouted out the window, "And for that, you can spend the rest of the tenner on a cheesecake slice for me from Co-op." And she glared until Scarlet turned the corner to get the bus. Scarlet didn't really need to get the bus to Grandma's. It was less than a mile away and it wasn't even raining. But as a typical teenager, she still wasn't going to walk anyway and walked as little as possible. The bus came about 30 seconds after she got to the bus stop, but Scarlet still nearly missed the bus as she was watching TikTok videos on her phone. The bus was mafting. It was really hot and nostril to armpit full. To make it worse, clearly somebody really had no idea what a bath or shower was and there was stench in the bus. She found the last empty seat and sat down in the middle of the back seat upstairs. It's not a good seat, that one, is it? Scarlet hated being pressed up against the general public like this. So to block out the surroundings, she started a Zoom call in full conversation volume with Amelia. On the phone, she said everything that had happened that morning about why she wasn't able to come round and why she had to go somewhere else instead. Many of the other passengers on the bus were getting really annoyed with Scarlet's loud conversation, but she remained oblivious as nobody actually said anything. After 10 minutes, Scarlet got off the bus and went into Boots. What was strange, though, is that a man and woman who looked like a pair of bagheads on the bus had followed her into Boots and seemed to be following her. Scarlet picked up the hand sanitizer and went into the chemist counter to get up the painkillers. The two baggers had left, but Scarlet could still see them outside the window stood at the bus stop. So thought that maybe she was just being daft and they weren't following her after all. Grandma's house was just off the high street and Scarlet put in her earphones and started walking down Grandma's street, when all of a sudden she felt a push from behind, and when she looked round, it was the Baggets. The Baggets were following her, and they stank. They raved off her coat, and they took her bag, her phone, and her bag with the things in for Grandma, and they ran off. Scarlet was devastated. She ran into Grandma's house, and she sobbed. And she said that a couple of Baggets stole all of her stuff and ran off. Oh, Grandma, they were so gone. Oh, Grandma, they hummed so bad they stank the bus out. Oh, Grandma, they had teeth like sledgehammered pianos. Bawled Scarlet. Oh, love. Poor love, said Grandma. Hang on a minute, said Grandma, suddenly feeling completely cured as anger took over. Did those two little weevils have dirty Donair caps from Sports Direct circa 1998 and orange Kappa trainers? Scarlet was shocked at the accurate description. Yeah. Scarlet gasped. And were they wearing makeup as if she'd fell into a tester display at Superdrug and did they have clogged up eyes with conjunctivitis? Grandma said even louder. Oh, yeah, said Scarlet. I know this pair of gloomy Louis. I'm going to call your mum, said Grandma, and picked up the part of this thing with wires and buttons on that her Grandma called a landline phone, which Scarlet had often scoffed at, but could now see how useful it was, because nobody had ever tried to steal the landline phone. Grandma tapped her fingernails on the buttoned part of the phone as she waited for Scarlet's mum to answer. Hiya, Colette. Scarlet's just been mugged by those dickweed druggy yellow kids you used to go to school with. Yeah. Yeah. No. Yeah. Yeah. Scarlet watched as Grandma, on the landline phone, Grandma seemed to be staring at the table the phone was on, as if looking at the phone screen, but there was nothing there. She would occasionally look up and glance in Scarlet's direction, and then look back at the table and at the phone. Yeah. No. Yeah, continued Grandma, who then suddenly slammed down the phone so hard that Scarlet was amazed the phone didn't break. Don't move and don't leave the house. Me and your mum are going to get your stuff back, said Grandma, who grabbed her brolly and dashed out the door. The house was suddenly silent. After about 20 minutes, the door opened again and Mum and Grandma had in their hands Scarlet's bag, phone and torn shopping bag with Grandma's painkillers. Right, said Grandma, me and your mum know them pillocks who robbed you, and long story short, got nearly all your stuff back, but it's too late for your coat, love. They'd flogged it for glue or whatever. What they did say, though, is that you were talking so loud on the bus, you were an easy target. They knew where you was, and what you was doing, and where you were going. They knew you were self-absorbed and unaware of your surroundings. They knew they could time it and get your stuff. Nice and easy. Unlucky for them, we know they are, and they won't bother you again. I made sure of that. Grandma gave Scarlet her phone and bag. The bag smelt really bad of the muggers. What do you say to your grandma? Said Scarlet's mum.
Thanks, Grandma. Thanks, Mum. Said Scarlet. I'm sorry for what I said. I'll never be gobby like that on the bus again or anywhere ever again.
The end.
And there you go. That's the story of Scarlet Caperon.
It's not a very well known story at all. Obviously, because I wrote it in about 10 minutes. Thanks for watching, everybody. Please scratch that in the comment section down below. You see, it's a decent story, I suppose. It's like the original, isn't it? Because the story of Little Red Riding Hood was effectively telling kids, don't talk to strangers and do as your parents tell you. But Scarlet, she was being all loud and obnoxious on the phone, on the bus, annoying everybody. And it turns out a couple of Baggets was listening to her and she made herself a target. No wonder she got robbed. So, what do you think of that? Or should be more quieter because it's probably night time whilst you're watching this. Thanks for watching. Please scratch, bell me, let me know in the comment section down below. What did you think of the story? How did her mum and grandma know these Baggets? Are they Baggets as well? I don't think so because they actually got the stuff back except for the coat. Anyway, scratch, bell me. Bye.